There is so much data. Where are you going to store this data? Do you think you will use Notepad, MS Excel, MS Access, or maybe your notebooks? Where do you think you can store the data? And that's where the term database comes into picture. And this is the reason why we have so many databases in the world, but why only Oracle? Why is Oracle number one? So I don't want to get in depth into it because I have a lot of topics to cover. So ultimately, the Oracle has more than 58% market share right now. So all the database clients, if you compare like all the clients in the world who want to use database, 58% of the companies are using Oracle database. So there is a reason why Oracle is the market leader, because of the performance, because of the compatibility, because of the speed, and a lot of other things. And there is a big history of Larry Ellison and the way Oracle has emerged today, right? So now in a database, the question is how the data will be stored. So one of the simplest ways is to store the data in the form of tables, right? So a lot of people, a lot of freshers, they ask me this question, why only tables? Why can't we have a different model of storing the data? Yes, we do have different model of storing the data. You might know that we also have a NoSQL, which is where you don't have a table at all inside the database. Now that concept is completely different. When you say tables, that means your database is nothing but it is RDBMS, Relational Database Management System. So when I say relational, it is nothing but tables. A relation is nothing but a table inside the Relational Database Management System. So you will understand a little more when we get in depth into the concepts. Now Oracle is an RDBMS, and in Oracle, when I say RDBMS, that means Relational Database Management System. Relation means table. Okay, so now the data inside the Oracle database is stored in the forms of tables. Now when it comes to tables, there are two things everybody knows, rows and columns, right? A table consists of very simple rows and columns. So it is very easy to store the data when it comes to a simple table where you have some rows and where you have some columns, because the readability increases and identification of data is pretty fast. When I say readability increases, let us create a quick student number. I'm just trying to create a quick table, and then student underscore name. Okay, I'm trying all my creativity on Notepad. So this is serial, or it should be roll number, and name I'll say John, and then we have Kevin, and so on, right? Now the first thing, when I say readability increases, it's easy to read through the rows, and the best part is the data identification is fast. So you want to know the name of the student whose number is 2, it's easy. You first go into this column, that is student number column. You scan through the entire table and find the roll number 2. And then suddenly you jump onto the student name column, and then you have the result. So that's the benefit of having a table. Your data readability, storage, efficiency, speed of retrieving the data all increases to a greater degree when compared to storing the data on a flat file. So when I say a flat file, simple, understand all this data is stored something like this, 2 space Kevin, and or maybe let's make it more horrible. If it is stored something like this, 3 comma AKS, and then 4 comma Mukesh. Now understand, if you have a file like this, how hard will it be to find the data, read the data, and of course, I'm not even talking about the database performance. Now, coming back to the tables, RDBMS, Relational Database Management System, nothing but it has tables, data is stored into tables, you have rows and you have columns. But I want to give you a different definition for rows and column, because in RDBMS concepts, rows and columns are referred with a different name. So you call rows as tuples and columns you call it as attributes. So these are the two names we generally use when it comes to RDBMS concepts. And then we also have table. We can also call it as relation, right? We'll understand why we call it as a relation when we are into the topic of normalization.